Hi friends, welcome to my channel. In this first video focused on productivity, we will explore the wonderful world of flashcards. I'll share a method I developed to create flashcards using Python to learn any language. You can find the written version of this video in an article I publish in my blog. I have added the link in the description. We'll take the example of flashcard creation to learn Mandarin, and we'll develop the workflow to build a deck of cards to practice your reading, pronunciation, and oral comprehension. This method can be used for any language that you want to learn using flashcards with Anki. Everything I will share today is based on my personal experience learning Mandarin in China. Learning a language can be a long journey, so staying motivated and having clear goals to aim along the way are essential. Because Mandarin uses pictorial system of writing words and sounds called Hanzi, it makes the journey even more challenging for any learner without a background in a similar language. In my quest for Chinese fluency, flashcards have been my best ally in improving my reading and pronunciation. Therefore, I would like to share my experience creating and using them to reach fluency in any language. The main mistake I did when I started to learn Mandarin was not following the advice of smart people that were promoting the use of flashcards. It's when I discovered the open source application Anki that my productivity exploded. Let's take an example. You want to practice your Mandarin and you have a list of vocabulary. Anki will first show you the Chinese character Hanzi. Here it's the word Tongzhi, which means notice, like for instance a written notice on a poster. And then Anki will show you the answer, so basically the translation, the phonetic transcription called pinyin, and the sound.
通知.
So now you have a kind of personal teacher that can help you to improve your Mandarin. The idea is to use Anki to do your self-assessment and repeat the cards until you have the right answers. You can use Anki as a personal teacher by following a process in three steps. Step one, Anki is showing you the Chinese character, or French, or English, or German, depending on the language you want to learn. And you try to guess
通知.
The translation in English, so here it's notice, like an official notice of office closure during holidays. Then you have the phonetic transcription. Here it's using the pinyin system that is used mainly in mainland China. So T-O-N-G-Z-H-I with the first tone on O and I. And finally the pronunciation 通知. Sorry for the Mandarin speakers in my audience. Guys, my pronunciation is not as good as before. Then you click and Anki is showing you the answers and ask you to assess your own answer. This assessment will impact the frequency this card will reappear later. The objective is that you remember all the vocabulary list. So you need to ask yourself several questions. Is it too easy? If yes, your daily session is finished and your card will be reappearing in 4 days. If no, do you want to see it again to practice? If yes, Anki will show it to you in 1 minute, and the process will continue until you have the good answer. So you usually say yes here when you have a wrong answer. If no, did you get the right answer? If yes, it means that you have the right answer, but you don't consider it easy. So your daily session is continuing. Anki will show it to you 10 minutes later. If you get the right answer the second time, you will see it the day after. If not, you will see it every 10 minutes until you get the right answer 2 consecutive times. Then you'll see the card later, like usually 1 day after. Isn't a cool way to learn? However, before arriving at that stage, you need to create the flashcards with phonetics, translation, and sounds. So now let's use Python to automate this part. Coming back to the context, I started to use this method when I was working in China. My objective was to accumulate vocabulary, to understand meetings in office, to communicate with warehouse operational teams, to order food at the restaurant, and for daily tasks like negotiating my rent with my landlord on the phone. The idea was to build Anki flashcards to get the vocabulary for this, with Chinese characters, pinyin phonetic transcription to make sure that I pronounce it the right way, and MP3 sound to practice my pronunciation. And plug all of this in Anki to organize my daily sessions when I was commuting or during lunch breaks at work. First, I need to build this vocabulary list. I use several sources. So first, the social networks. I access them via APIs. So it's to get the internet slang or the way of talking of young people by performing some NLP on tweets or Weibo in China that are trending. Then you can use Excel files. So it's a very good source to get the vocabulary or logistics and supply chain, for instance, by using financial follow-ups or Excel operational dashboards. And of course, emails. If you want to learn how to read emails, it's a good idea to take emails and extract the terms that are used. And finally, PDF reports. A lot of documentation, especially technical documentation, are in PDF reports. If you can extract the technical terms from there, then you can build very efficient vocabulary list. So then, yeah, as I said, you extract the words, you process them, and you format them in data frames. You add the phonetic transcription. In Chinese, it will be pinyin, but you can have another phonetic translation for your own language. And finally, you want to download this MP3 sound for the pronunciation. Step one, let's build the vocabulary list. So you can build it from emails, as I said. You can use the Win32 library of Python to connect to your Outlook mailbox, or from PDF reports using PyPDF2, and also Excel files, of course, using Pandas. Next step, you want to add the phonetics. For Chinese Mandarin, you want the pinyin that you can populate using the library jieba. The intermediate result is a panda data frame with the Chinese words in characters, the English or French translation, and the pinyin transcription. Last step, you want to get the oral pronunciation. For this, I use Google TTS Python library that takes the Chinese character and returns an MP3 file with the sound.
通知.
Now you're good to implement your learning process. Of course, you can find all the code in the article link in the description. Now that I showed you the automation part, let me share you my learning methodology. It has nothing special. It's just a way of learning reading, pronunciation, using the same exercise. Step 1. Anki is showing you the Chinese character, or French or Italian, depending on the language you learn. And you have to ask yourself, do I know the translation? I think it's supermarket. If your answer is wrong, press again until you have the right one. Else, you continue and you have a look at the pinyin. Is the pinyin good? If the answer is no, press again until you have the right one. Else, you can have a look at the pronunciation.
超市.
Did you pronounce the same way she did? If no, you press again. Else, you're good with this card. At the end, you have validated your oral comprehension, your reading, and your pronunciation. To conclude, you found a way to fluency. Congratulations! You can find the details in the article. I've put the link in the description. I hope my explanations were clear enough for you to replicate the process for your own journey of learning a language. If you have questions or face issues collecting phonetics or sound, feel free to share them in the comment section. I'll try my best to answer.